Tonight's Bible reading is taken from Matthew chapter 8, verses 18 to 34. 今晚的经文是取自于马太福音8章18至34节。马太福音8章18节，耶稣见许多人围着他，就吩咐渡到那边去。有一个文士来对他说：“夫子，你无论往哪里去，我要跟从你。” 耶稣说：“狐狸有洞，天空的飞鸟有窝，人子却没有枕头的地方。”又有一个门徒对耶稣说：“主啊，容我先回去埋葬我的父亲。”耶稣说：“任凭死人埋葬他们的死人，你跟从我吧。”耶稣上了船，门徒跟着他。海里忽然起了暴风，甚至船被波浪掩盖。 耶稣却睡着了，门徒来叫醒了他，说：“主啊，救我们，我们丧命了。”耶稣说：“你们这小信的人哪，为什么胆怯呢？”于是起来斥责风和海，风和海就大大的平静了。众人稀奇说：“这是怎样的人，连风和海也听从他了。”耶稣基督到那边去，来到加大拉人的地方。 就有两个被鬼附的人从坟营里出来迎着他，极其凶猛，甚至没有人能从那条路上经过。他们喊着说：“神的儿子，我们与你有什么相干？时候还没有到，你就上这里来叫我们受苦吗？”离他们很远，有一大群猪吃食，鬼就央求耶稣说：“若把我们赶出去，就打发我们进入猪群吧。”耶稣说：“去吧。” 鬼就出来进入猪群，全群忽然闯下山崖，投在海里淹死了。放猪的就逃跑进城，将这一切事和被鬼附的人所遭遇的都告诉人。合成的人都出来迎接耶稣，既见了就央求他离开他们的境界。这是上帝的话语，感谢上帝。
Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ.
主内弟兄姐妹，大家晚上好。
And once again, the Lord be with you.
愿主与你们同在。也与你同在。
Now I'm very excited to share tonight's word of God with you from this passage.
所以呢，今天晚上呢，我也很兴奋能够使用这些的经文来向大家分享这个的信息。Because
all the songs that we sing got to do with it.
因为今天我们所唱的所有的歌呢，都跟这篇道有关。And
what we have witnessed during the baptism has got to do with it.
刚才我们所看到的这个洗礼也是跟这篇道有关。
And so tonight's message, I believe God will speak to many, many of us, if not all of us.
所以今天晚上的这篇信息呢，我相信神会对我们当中有很多人说话。
If you have not got a bulletin, okay, please get one or scan. I believe probably you have scanned it just now. Okay, for a bulletin. All right, I've written something about baptism and explaining a little bit more about baptism.
所以呢，你们也能够去拿一份的汇报，或者是拿这个的电子版的汇报。那么在这个的汇报呢，我也写了一些有关洗礼的事情。Baptism
is just a first step, a first baby step of your whole journey with Jesus Christ.
那么洗礼呢，是你跟耶稣基督的这个整个的这个同行的旅程上的一小步。
And tonight, I'd like to share with all of us about the challenges or the hurdles of following Jesus.
所以今天晚上呢，我要和大家分享的这篇的信息，就是叫做跟随耶稣的挑战，或者是一些的障碍。If
you have been a Christian long enough, for some time, you will know that following Jesus, or truly following Jesus, and seriously following Jesus. Is not easy.
那么，如果你已经信主一段的时间，那么你会知道，如果你要认真的来去跟随耶稣的话呢，这是不容易的一件事情。Because
following Jesus, the path of following Jesus is not a bed of roses.
因为你要跟随耶稣的这条路呢，并不是一帆风顺的路。And
the passage that we had just read a while ago testifies to it as well.
而刚才我们所读的这篇经文也让我们看到这样子的事情。
Let's bow our heads for prayer.
所以让我们先来低头祷告。
Lord, even as we look into a very serious passage of your word, your truth, Lord, we pray that our hearts be open to listen to you.
所以天父上帝，今天晚上当我们来到你的面前，敞开我们的心来聆听你的话语、你的真理的时候，愿你来向我们说话。
Lord, take away every distractions.
神啊，你拿走一切分心的事情。
And in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that the works of the evil one to confuse us, to close our ears and our hearts will be gone in Jesus' name.
我们也要奉你的名来斥责魔鬼一切的工作，一切让我们感到混乱，一切让我们感到疑惑的事情，我们都要奉耶稣基督的名来斥责。
And our Heavenly Father, we come before you with a humble heart.
所以天父上帝，我们要以谦卑的心来到你的面前。
And we pray the prayer of Samuel, the man of God, speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.
我们也要使用你的仆人撒母耳的祷告来祈求神，你来向我们说话，因你的仆人在聆听。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣基督的名字祷告。
Amen. 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 Okay, say to your friend beside you before we look into the Word of God, let's follow Jesus.
告诉你旁边的朋友，让我们跟随耶稣。
Now it is said that there are three types of people.
那么曾经有人说呢，这世界上有三种人。
Those who make things happen.
那么第一种人就是那些促使事情发生的人。
And the second group of people are those who watch things happen, or people who make things happen.
第二种人呢，就是去观察那些使事情发生的人。
And the third is those who wonder.What has happened?
然后第三种人呢，就是那些想知道或者是不知道到底发生了什么事情的人。
I'm not sure which part, which kind of person are you?
所以我不知道你是属于哪一种人。
All right. Now, having the ability to do something is one thing. Being willing to do something is another.
所以如果你有能力去做一回啊，去做一些的事情是一回事，可是你愿不愿意去做呢，却是另外一回事。
There are many people who are able, but few who are willing to go an extra mile to help others.
有很多人他们有能力，可是呢，却有很少的人是愿意多走一里路来去帮助那些有需要的人。
2 weeks ago, we looked on the we have studied the first part of the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 8.
所以呢，在两个星期前呢，我们就看到这个马太福音上半段的这一篇的经文。
And we recall the encounter of the leper with Jesus.
那么这个马太福音八章上半段的时候呢，就说到有这个长大麻风病的人跟耶稣相遇。
And the Bible says, and we read in English first. Ready, one, two, go. A man with leprosy came and knelt before him and said, "Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean." And Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man. "I am willing," he said, "be clean."Immediately, he was cleansed of his leprosy.
有一个长大麻风的来拜他说，主若肯，必能叫我洁净了。耶稣伸手摸他说，我肯，你洁净了吧。他的大麻风立刻就洁净了。
In the first part of chapter 8, we have seen three encounters of different people with Jesus.
在马太福音八章的上半段呢，我们就看到有三种的人，他们跟耶稣有了这个的相遇。
And all three encounters we saw and we learned of the willingness of Jesus, firstly in helping the leper, second in going the second mile for the centurion, and thirdly, compassionately healing the sick, the demon oppressed,or the demon possessed.
所以我们看到在这三组人里面呢，我们看到首先耶稣他是非常愿意的来去医治这个长大麻风病的人，然后呢，他也很愿意的走第二里的路来去帮这个百夫长，然后接下来他也医治了很多这些被鬼附、被辖制的人。
Now in the second half, we are seeing a total opposite.
可是在接下来的这个下半段呢，我们会看到是完全相反的事情。
We are seeing a major contrast, a big contrast, the opposite of willingness, that is reluctance and even resistance or rejection to believe in Jesus Christ.
在这下半段呢，我们会看到一个强烈的对比，就是我们会看到他们是不肯，甚至是拒绝来去相信和跟随耶稣。
Again, we are going to see three examples, three challenges, or three hurdles that may prevent us to wholly follow Jesus.
所以呢，我们将会一起来看三个的例子，然后当中会有三个的挑战，然后呢，这三个的到底是什么三个的拦阻会来去拦阻到我们来去跟随耶稣呢？三个的障碍。
And I want to say that all these three hurdles happens to you and I in different time and different seasons of our life.
我想说的就是这三个的障碍呢，会在我们生命里面不同的时期、不同的季节会出现。
We will face these challenges. We will face these hurdles.
我们会面对到这样子的挑战和障碍。
And how we respond and how we overcome those challenges will be the key of how.We follow Jesus.
我们如何来去回应，我们如何来去面对这些的障碍呢？将会是我们来去跟随耶稣的一个的秘诀。
And the first one is the hurdles of comfort zone.
首先我们要来看的就是这个舒适区的障碍。
Does the English say together with me aloud? Ready, one, two, go. The hurdle of.
我们一起来说舒适区的障碍。
Okay, 一起啊，中文的一起，大声一点好不好？比英文更大声。一二三。
舒适区的障碍。
Now in Matthew 18 to 22, just now we have already heard in Chinese, read in Chinese, now I only read it in English.
So we're going to look at Matthew 8:18-22.
And very quickly, in verse 18, the Bible says, And when Jesus saw the crowd around him, he gave orders to cross the other side of the lake. Then a teacher of the law came to him and said, Teacher, I will follow you wherever you go. Okay, probably he sing the song, I will follow you. Okay, but Jesus replied, okay, foxes have dens and birds have nests, but the Son of Man have no place to lay his head. Another disciple said to him, Lord, let me first go and bury my father. But Jesus told him, follow me and let the dead bury the dead. One of the hardest things in our life and one of the most fearful things in our life is to step out of our comfort zone.
在我们生命中期间一件最可怕的事情或者是最艰难的事情呢就是要踏出我们的舒适区。
Now, comfort zone is the space that we feel safe and are in control of.
舒适区呢就是一个让我们感到很安稳然后是我们能够掌控的空间。
It may be our lifestyles or the way we do things.
它可以是我们的生活方式或者是我们处事的方式。
It may be the comfort of our homes or our environment.
它可以是我们家里或者是我们周围的环境所带来的安宁。
It may be relationships or connections that we have.And all the attachments that we have that we find so hard to part with.
或者是有一些的人际关系，我们所有的一些的联系，我们觉得很难要割舍这些的关系。
Now in this passage in verse 18 to 22, we saw and we read about two persons who have a desire to follow Jesus.
所以在十八到二十二节这里呢，我们就看到有两个人，他们呢就表明了他们要跟随耶稣的渴望。
Now, to follow Jesus in this context and in this passage is not just merely to believe and to be a disciple, but it's actually the intention, the desire to follow Jesus or to go with Jesus servingand also preaching the gospel everywhere.
在这里，当他们说到要跟从耶稣的时候呢，这些的跟从不是说你只是信主，然后啊成为他的门徒而已。这里的跟从就是说到他们会跟着耶稣到处去，然后呢就是去传扬福音，来去侍奉。
So the first man, which is the teacher of the law, when he said that he wants to follow Jesus, Jesus spelled out the price or the cost of following him.
所以当在这里的第一个人就是一个文士，当他说他要跟随耶稣的时候呢，耶稣就告诉他说了跟随他的代价是什么。
Jesus did not say, "Well, very, very good. Come on, let's go, let's go."
耶稣没有说啊，很好，很好，来来来，我们走吧。
In fact, Jesus.Put before him the cost of it, the price you have to pay if you are really serious of following me or joining me in preaching the gospel.
耶稣是很坦白的来去告诉他，你要跟从我的时候，你所要付出的代价是什么。
And he says that foxes have dens, okay, and birds have nests, but the Son of Man has no place to place or lay his head.
然后耶稣就告诉他说：“狐狸有洞，天空的飞鸟有窝，人子却没有枕头的地方。”
What Jesus meant here is that the path of following and serving together with Him is a narrow road, a difficult road, and a sacrificial road.
所以耶稣在这里他所要带出的意思就是说，跟随他是要走一条窄路，是一条艰难的路，你必须要付出牺牲的路。
Would you be willing?
你会愿意吗?
Would you be willing to leave your comfort zone?
你会愿意的来去离开你的舒适区。
Would you be willing to leave your comfort zone and step into the path of uncertainties, just like not having a place to sleep?
你是否愿意离开你的舒适区，然后踏上一个不确定的道路，就好像你没有地方睡觉。
There was a complaint about youth camp.
那么在 youth camp 的时候呢，青少年营的时候呢，就有一个的投诉。
Joy will want to cry already when she hears this.
Joy 听到的话，她就会要哭了。
There was a complaint okay, about our recent youth camp.
那么在我们最近的这个青少年营呢，就有一个的投诉。
All right, one mother was very angry.
有一个的母亲呢，她很生气。
Because, all right, you said that you publish and you said that it's a conference.
她说你们就是打啊，就是宣传的时候呢，就说这是一个的特会。
But you run the thing, holding like a camp, and my son sleep in the classroom.
然后，可是你们进行的方式呢，就像一个的营会一样，而我的儿子呢，就要睡在这个课室里面。
Following Jesus, sleep in classroom.
所以你要跟随耶稣，你是要睡在课室的。
Foxes have dens.
狐狸有洞。
Birds have nest.
天空的飞鸟有窝。
But the Son of Man has no place even to lay his head.
人子却没有枕头的地方。
Are you willing to follow Jesus? Not only in good times, not only in your comfort, but also in difficulties and also in lack.
你是否愿意就是不仅在你啊顺利 舒服的时候来跟随耶稣，也是甚至愿意在你很艰难的时候啊来去跟随耶稣呢？
One of the crises of the modern church is that we are only willing to follow Jesus when life is easy.
现代的教会面临着一个的危机，就是很多人他们只会在生活顺利的时候才愿意跟随耶稣。
All right.I remember having a conversation with some young people and said, let's go for mission. And the first question is, got internet or not?
我记得曾经有一次我就挑战一群的年轻人说，来我们一起去做短宣。他们第一个问题是什么呢？有没有的啊，这个 internet 有没有的上网？
Would you go even if there is no internet?
如果没有的上网的话，你是否也愿意去呢？
Would you go even though you don't have a nice toilet like the ones that we have in St. Patrick?
你是否就是即便是没有像圣巴特堂这样子有这样好的厕所你是否也愿意去呢？
Would you go again when it is, you don't have the comfort?
所以就算是没有这样子舒适的环境，你是否愿意去呢？
The second person who wants to follow Jesus or to serve together with Jesus, okay, comes with his terms and conditions.
然后在这里的第二个人，他想要跟随耶稣，可是呢，他却带有他的条件。
He's saying, Lord, I'm willing.
他说，主啊，我愿意。
But let me bury my father first.
可是呢，你先让我回去埋葬我的父亲。
Now, somehow Jesus answered him in a very, very shocking and uncomfortable manner.
可是呢，耶稣对给他的回答呢，却是一个让人感觉到很震惊，让人感觉到很不舒服的方式。
He came to Jesus and said, "Let me bury my father."
他来到耶稣的面前，他说：“你先容我先去埋葬我的父亲。”
But Jesus' answer was a denial, denying the man's request.
可是耶稣的回答呢，却是拒绝了这个人的请求。
Jesus did not allow him to.
耶稣不容许他。
That simple request, a very logical request, okay?To many of us, by first reading or by first time hearing it, again, may be a shocking news to us.
所以这是一个很简单的要求，也是一个很合理的要求。可是耶稣的回答可能会让所有的人，或者是第一次听见的人，你们会觉得很震惊。
And Jesus even said even harder, stronger word, let the dead bury the dead.
然后耶稣也用了非常严厉的话语，他说任凭死人埋葬他们的
死人。As if Jesus was teaching us to disregard our family.
看来好像耶稣在教导我们不要理会我们的家人。
Definitely not.
可是这绝对不是这样。
It was not.
不是这样的。
Though the first reading may sound like it.
可是当我们这样子读的时候呢，可能你会有这样子的感觉。
But if we understand the whole context, if we understand the culture of that time, It was not.
可是如果我们明白他的整个背景，当时候他们的文化的话呢，我们就知道不是这样子的。
Firstly, I want to establish that the Bible teaches us to honor our parents.
首先我要再提醒的就是，圣经教导我们要孝敬我们的父母。
In fact, honoring parents was the first place in all human relations as stated in the Ten Commandments.
其实在这个十诫里面，所有有关于人际关系的诫命里面，这个孝敬父母是在第一条的。
And I thank God that our dear Jefferson, all right? Jefferson, okay. I'm glad that Jefferson, okay, learned to forgive the elders.
我很高兴看到 Jefferson 他能够来去原谅他的长辈。
It is the right thing to do.
这是对的事情。
Whether it is his parents or teachers or someone elder.
无论是父母也好啊，老师也好，只要是长辈。
But what does it mean when Jesus says, "You follow me and let the dead bury the dead"?
可是当耶稣说任凭死人埋葬他们的死人，你跟从我吧，他的意思是什么呢
？First, let us understand the request.Of this young man.
首先，让我们要来先去明白这个年轻人他的要求是什么。
Let me bury my father first.
他说让容我先回去埋葬我的父亲。
Now, what the person is saying is that he will only follow Jesus full time in preaching the kingdom of God after his father dies.
其实这个年轻人的意思呢，就是说他要就是等到他的父亲去世之后呢，他才来全时间的来去跟随耶稣，来去传扬福音。
And it is very unlikely that his father has already died.
所以就不太，他的父亲是不太可能是已经去世了。
Because if it was so, all right, he would not have been with Jesus at that point of time and asked to follow him and also making that request.
因为如果他的父亲在当时候是去世了的话呢，他在那个时候就不会在耶稣那里来去听耶稣，然后来去给耶稣这样子的要请求。
Now the disciple.By saying, let me bury my father first, what the disciple is asking or request is for time.
所以这个年轻人当他说容我先回去埋葬我的父亲，这年轻人其实他在要求的是什么呢？就是要延长时间。
In other words, he's saying that Jesus, I'm willing to follow you.
换句话，他就是要跟耶稣说，耶稣，我是愿意来跟从你的。
But give me time.
可是你给我时间。
To remain with my father and care for him until he passes.
你先给我时间。我先要回到家里来去照顾我的父亲，直到他去世为止。
Now, this request was obviously, okay, asking for indefinite period of time.
所以其实他这样子的要求呢，是要在要啊，是要对耶稣说啊，要求一个啊不确定的一个的延长的时间。
Because you wouldn't know when your father will die.
因为你不知道你的父亲会在什么时候去世。
It could be months, it could be years.
可以是几个月，可以是很多年。
So what Jesus is saying to him is that get your commitment and your priority right.
可是耶稣对他说的是什么呢？就是你要先摆好你的正确的尾声和优先次序。
I said again, what Jesus is saying to him when Jesus replies is get your commitment and your priority right.
所以耶稣的回答呢，是要对他说，你要正确的来去摆好你的优先次序和你的尾声。
And Jesus said, you follow me.
然后耶稣说，你跟从我吧。
Now,
现在。
Okay, Luke's gospel put it even clearer.
在路加福音呢，就会更清楚的说到这一点。
In the gospel of Luke, chapter 9 and verse 60 puts it even clearer. And Jesus said to him, let the dead bury their own dead, but you go and proclaim the kingdom of God.
路加福音九章六十节这样子说，耶稣说任凭死人埋葬他们的死人，你只管去传扬神国的道。
The preaching of the gospel takes precedence and takes a greater urgency.
所以传福音呢是占优先的次序，然后也是更加的紧迫。
It calls you to follow.
所以他是在呼召你来去跟随。
Because if you wait, the time may never come.
如果你等的话呢，这个的时间呢，这个你就不知道要等到哪一天了。
Many people who want to serve the Lord nowadays say that, wait till I retire first.
所以今天呢，也有很多人要侍奉神的，他们就说你等啊等等等，等到有一天我退休了。
Or wait till I'm rich enough first to support myself.
或者是等到我存够钱了，可以能够养活自己。
Then I follow.
我才去跟随。
And that's not what Jesus demands.
可是呢，这并不是耶稣所要的。
What then does it mean? Let the dead bury the dead.
然后当耶稣说任凭死人埋葬他们的死人，这句话又是什么意思呢？
Now, of course,Jesus is not saying let the dead father bury himself.
当然，耶稣并不是对那个人说，你让那已经去世的父亲自己去埋葬自己。
Are you with me?
你明白吗？
Okay. It may sound very rude.
听起来好像很粗鲁。
But that's not the meaning.
可是呢，他的意思不是这样子的。
Now the Jews, especially during that time also, the Jews used the word dead. Okay, dead. Okay, to express something that has no longer any influence on them or on us.
我们要明白到在当时候他们这些的犹太人呢，他们会用死这个字呢来去表达某些的东西它在我们身上不会再产生影响。
For example, like we quote, for example, the Bible also write, to be dead to the law or to be dead to sin.
比如说在圣经里面我们会看到的一些经文就是比如说在律法上也是死的。
Okay.
或者是对罪也当作自己是死的。
All right. To be dead to the law or to be dead to the sin means that the law and sin have no longer influence or control over our life.
所以当圣经说在律法上也是死了，然后像罪也当看自己是死的时候呢，这两节的经文其实就是要告诉我们说，律法和罪它已经不能够再对我们的生命产生影响或者是控制。
So when Jesus says, "Let the dead, okay, bury their own dead," it is not an insult.
所以当耶稣说让死人来去埋葬他们的死人的时候呢，这并不是在侮辱他们。
What it simply means is that those who are not interested or involved in my work, let them do the burying.
他所要带出的意思就是说，让那些对我的事工不感兴趣的人，或是不想参与在里面的人，就让他们去做这个埋葬的工作。
But you, your duty is to follow me and to preach the gospel.
可是你的责任呢，就是要来去跟从我，来去传福音。
Let me illustrate very, very quickly because of time.
Okay,
can I have a group of you?
Okay,
all the front row of girls. How come there's no guys? Okay, all the third row of guys, all of you, five of you, come up quickly. Come, run up to the stage. Come, quickly. Okay, run up to the stage. All right. Okay, 走，快点，不要跌倒就是。Okay, yeah. Another one. Okay, very quickly.
All right,
this will illustrate what it means by all this talk. Okay,
然后我很快的向大家描述一下这些交谈的意思。
Okay, so we are, during that time, a lot of people want to follow Jesus. They are also in their community, they don't stand so straight. It's like,in a group, in a circle.
所以在当时代呢，就有很多的人，他们想要跟随耶稣。
Okay, we relax. All right. It is just like that. Okay. And so, one of them, the teacher of the law, and said that, okay, Master, I want to follow you.
所以呢，这有一个的文士，他就说，主啊，让我啊，我要跟从你。
Meaning that because they know that Jesus is going around preaching the gospel.
意思就是说，他也知道耶稣是会到处去传福音的。
So the men, these are all group. We are all, lepak together, and things like that. And then suddenly, he said, "Lord, I want to follow you."
所以这群人呢，他们是常常一起困的。所以呢，今天有一天呢，这人就跟耶稣说，我要跟从你。
And the Lord just turned to him and said, "Foxes have dens, but birds have nests, but the Son of Man have no place to lay."Even his head.
主耶稣就对他说：“狐狸有洞啊，飞鸟有窝，可是人子没有枕头的地方。”
In other words, Jesus saying, "Are you sure?"
所以换句话说，耶稣是在问他说：“你确定吗
？”Are you serious?
你是认真的吗
？It's not an easy road.
不是一条容易的路。
You get what I mean?
你明白我的意思吗
？And then Jesus turned to another one.
然后耶稣又对另外一个人说
：“And he knows that this is a disciple.”
他知道这是要门徒来的。
And he said that.No, this is in the context, all jalan-jalan, lepak-lepak. Okay?
这是在他们一起。
And so after answering him, Jesus turned around and said, you, follow me.
然后呢，耶稣就转向这个人说，你来跟从我。
And Jesus is saying to this young man, you follow me, let's go and let's preach the gospel.
所以耶稣就对他说, 来, 我们, 你来跟从我们, 一起去传福音。
And so this young man suddenly, Lord,
所以就吓到这个年轻人了。
Can wait or not?
可以等吗?
Let me bury my father first.
先让我回去埋葬我的父亲。
You get what I mean?
你明白我的意思吗?
When I said, let me bury my father, doesn't mean that my father is already died. No. Let me wait until my father died first, then I follow you.
他说让我回去先埋葬我的父亲，不是，并不是说他的父亲已经去世了，而是说你要等到我父亲去世之后呢，我才来跟从你。
So Jesus says no.
耶稣告诉他不是的，不可以。
Let the dead bury their own dead.
耶稣说任凭死人埋葬他们的死人。
Come.
你来跟从我。
Come follow me.
你来跟从我。
Are you with me?
你明白吗？
You get the picture now?
你现在可以想象到这个的画面吗？
You understand how it works now?
你现在可以明白到这个的啊，他们是怎么样的互动吗？
It is not that Jesus was being rude to this young man.
就耶稣并不是很不礼貌的来去对待这个的年轻人。
It was not that Jesus was insulting this young man.
耶稣也并不是在羞辱这个的年轻人。
But that is the whole situation because this young man is basically said, "Wait, ah, Lord, ah, wait, ah, wait. I want, but wait."
他乃是在跟耶稣说啊，主，你等啊等，你等先，先等先。
How many of you have ever said, "Wait, Lord"?
有多少个人你们曾经对主说过，主啊，等？
And until today, it's probably 5 years, 10 years over and still waiting.
等到今天五年、十年过后，还是在等。
Are you with me?
你明白吗？
And that was the situation.
所以这个的情况就是这样的。
And that was it. Okay, thanks, guys.
谢谢这一群弟兄。
All right, give that a big, big hand, shall we?
给他们一个掌声。
So Jesus, you follow me.
所以耶稣就说你来跟从我。
Go preach the gospel.
来去传福音。
Because the preaching of the gospel cannot wait.
因为传福音是不能够等的。
What Jesus answered the two persons is basically spelling out the cost of following him.
所以耶稣在对这个两个人所说的话呢，就是在告诉他们跟从他的代价。
Comfort zone.
所以这就是舒适区。
Everybody say with me, comfort zone.
我们一起说舒适区。
That's the first, the hurdle of a comfort zone.
所以这就是舒适区的障碍。
Many of us are not willing to pay the price is because we are not and we cannot and are not willing to jump over the hurdle of our comfort zone.
所以我们很多人不愿意来去付出的这个的代价啊，因为我们不愿意来去跳出这个舒适区的障碍。
And we are seeing this more and more in the 21st century.
而且在二十一世纪呢，我们会看到越来越多这样。
The second is the hurdle of control.
第二个的障碍呢，就是掌控的障碍。
And in this passage, okay, all right. Apart from the hurdle of the comfort zone, we also face a crisis of faith.
所以在啊这个的啊舒啊除了有舒适区的障碍之外呢，我们也会面对到在我们信心上的一个的危机。
And verse 23 to verse 27 talks about the disciples. They were all in the same boat with Jesus. And as they were crossing the lake, they were caught by a very, very violent storm.
所以在23到27节呢，这里就讲到啊，耶稣跟他的门徒呢就要过这个河，然后突然间啊过这个海，可是呢突然间呢那里就啊起了大风浪。
For sure, the disciples panicked.
所以很肯定的就是门徒他们就很慌张。
They were scared.
他们很害怕。
And you better be.
确实会这样子。
Now imagine, now, to put to today's context, imagine that you were in that SQ flight, you know, that Singapore flight.
放在今天的情况。
Flying, and then that was caught in the turbulence.
你想象下，如果今天你是坐在这个的最近的那个新加坡航空的那一班机，然后呢，突然间就遇到了这个的乱流。
Imagine that you're in that plane in that turbulence and you drop 170 feet in 5 seconds.
然后呢，你想象一下，你是坐在这个的飞机里面，然后在五秒钟以内呢，这个啊你就坠落了178尺。
It is not go flying from here to KK and sometimes you know you go.
并不是好像从这里去亚比，有时候那个飞机会晃摇晃。
Okay, it is not that you are in a flight and then in a flight and suddenly.
并不是说你只是摇晃，然后突然间掉了一下这样子。
It is 178 feet.
是178尺的坠落。
18 floors drop.
你想下是掉了18层楼。
In 4.7 seconds.
5秒钟。
If you don't panic,
如果你不感到紧张，
you are not human.
你就不是人。
Are you with me?
你明白吗？
I believe from everyone from that time onward. After that, I mean, Singapore Airlines have not faced that in such a big way. I tell you, whoever was in that plane will be traumatized for a long, long time.
我告诉你，那些坐在这个飞机里面的人，他们肯定会有啊，就是会啊，就是啊，就是很害怕。
Let me read the passage very quickly again because of time. And then when they got into the boat and the disciples followed him, suddenly a furious storm came up on the lake. And so the waves swept over the boat. Water came into the boat, okay? All right? And Jesus was sleeping. Everybody said, sleeping.
耶稣睡着了。
Just like some of you are sleeping now.
就好像现在有些人睡着了。
Okay, now Jesus was sleeping. Now the disciples went and woke him up, saying, "Lord, save us, we are going to drown." And he replied, you of little faith, why are you so afraid? Then he got out and rebuked the winds and the waves, and then it was completely calm. The men were amazed and asked, "What kind of man is this? Even the winds and the waves obey him." Jesus was sleeping.
所以在那个时候，耶稣他睡着了。
Completely unperturbed.
他是完全啊，就是很镇定的。
Of course, the disciples woke him up, panicking, and in return they got scolding instead.
可是门徒却把他叫醒了，结果就被他骂了。
You of little faith, why are you so afraid?
他说：“你们这小信的人，为什么胆怯呢？”
And then, of course, Jesus got up.Face the winds and the storm, command it to be still, and everything calm.
所以当然，耶稣他也起来了，然后他就斥责这个风和浪，命令他们平静。然后呢，这个的风和浪就真的是平静了。
The Bible says here that the disciples were amazed.
所以圣经在这里说，门徒他们感到很稀奇。
The Greek word here, taumazo, okay, taumazo, meaning to say they were actually awestruck, jaw dropped.
那么在这个、啊、稀奇的希腊原文呢就是 Tomazo 他的意思就是说他们很震惊就是目瞪口呆
They have never seen such a thing before
就因为从来没有看过这样子的事情
The violent wind suddenly by a command went still
这个的风暴突然间就是因为一个命令而平静了
The second time that in the New Testament uses this Tomazo is when they saw Jesus was lifted up to heaven
在圣经里面第二次使用 Tomazo 这个希腊原文的时候呢就是当他们看到耶稣升天的那个时候
And they were like this and it is a good thing that we have camera so that you can see okay?
他们的表情是怎样的呢你们看荧幕、
okay? 不是当然看我你也是要同样做、okay. they were Tomazo they were awestruck they literally when saw Jesus went up to heaven they
就是这样子的表情
Jaw drop!
那个整个下巴都掉下来了。
Even the winds and the waves obey him.
他们就说连风和海也听从他了。
Now it is equally easy to read this passage and to be amazed today.
所以有时候当我们读这些的经文的时候呢我们也是很容易就是感到很惊讶。
But when you are in the storm,
可是如果是你在这个的风暴当中
It often turns into a very different story.
可是这个故事呢，就会变得不一样了。
We are living in a culture of very little trust.
我们现在是活在一个信靠程度非常低的文化里面。
To trust God.
所以讲到要来去信靠神。
To have faith in God.
要对神有信心。
Is often a very academic matter.Whereby we only discuss in cell group and Bible study.
这样子的词语呢，会变成很学术化，就是我们只会在小组或者是查经的时候我们才会讲到这些的字。
It's only good for discussion.
来去讨论就是彼此讨论的时候才讲到。
But to totally trust God. that He will take care of us, our family, our children, our future, to completely trust God is a very hard thing to do.
可是当要我们完全的来信靠神，信靠他是能够眷顾我们，我们的家庭，我们的孩子，我们的未来，其实这是一件很难的事情。
Why?
为什么呢？
Because we fear losing control.
因为我们害怕我们会失去掌控。
We were taught and trained since young, okay, to be in control and to take control.
因为从小我们就被教导我们要来去掌控一切。
And we were even told, if you don't help yourself, no one can help you.
甚至有人告诉我们说, 如果我们自己不努力的话, 就, 啊, 没有人能够帮助我们了。
So we somehow want to be assured with some kind of security.
所以呢, 我们就是要有一些的安全感。
So to give up everything is scary.
所以当, 啊, 说到要放弃一切的时候呢,
and to give up this right, and to give up this control is scary.
然后要放弃这个的掌控权, 我们也是会觉得很可怕。
And to trust God, whom we cannot see with our naked eye, is even scarier.
所以当说要来去信靠这个我们肉眼所看不见的神，我们也是会觉得很可怕。
It's even more difficult.
是更难了。
You get what I mean?
你明白我的意思吗？
Now for example,
例如,
say I'm a millionaire.
我是一个的百万富翁。
And all of you know that I'm a millionaire.
然后你们每一个人都知道我是百万富翁。
Okay? And I said to Annie, Annie, trust me.
然后呢，我就跟 Annie 说， Annie， 你要相信我。
If you have any financial problem, don't worry. I am here to back you up.
如果你有任何经济上的困难的话呢，不用担心，我会来帮助你。
You know, it's easier for her to trust in me because she knows, she sees me, she knows me being a millionaire.
我去相信她是更容易的一件事情，因为我认识她，我知道她是百万富翁。
Now. To turn over the other side and to trust God, whom you cannot see.
可是如果转向另外一边来去相信那个你完全看不到的神,
and to trust,
然后相信他,
to let go of this control, 啊,
信靠他来去放开你的这个掌控权,
is both scary and difficult.
你会觉得很可怕，很困难。
And that is why we have very little faith.
这就是为什么我们都是小信的人。
As I said, in the 21st century, our church and our diocese is facing this kind of crisis.
所以在这个21世纪里面，我们的教会，我们的教区也在面对着这样子的危机。
I'm talking specially for our young people and our young adults.
我也在对所有的年轻人还有我们的职青来说话。
Very few young people and very young adults are responding to full-time ministry nowadays.
今天有很少的年轻人或者是职青愿意的来回应全职侍奉。
Many of them fell and desire or wanting to follow and to serve Jesus.
有很多人他们有这样子的感觉，也有这样子的呼召说要来去全职侍奉。
But they fear to trust God for their future.
可是呢，他们却害怕，他们不敢为他们的未来来去信靠神。
They somehow don't see their future in following and serving God.
他们似乎就在这个全职侍奉神的道路上，他们看不见他们自己的未来。
I say it again. They somehow don't see and trust their future. They don't have that security over the future in serving God.
他们似乎是在全职侍奉神的这条道路上，他们看不见他们的未来，他们没有安全感。It's
not that they don't have faith.
并不是他们没有信心。They
have.
有的。
They believe in Jesus.
他们是相信耶稣的。They
sing the song.
还唱了这些歌。What
song do you sing just now?
刚才你们唱什么歌？
What song you sing already?
I have decided. We'll
be singing one of the songs later, right?
等下还要再唱这首歌。
I like the second song. I want to sing the second song again.
等下我们会再唱那个第二首歌。
They have that faith to sing.
有这样子的信心去唱歌。
But have that faith to step out.
可是有没有这样子的信心踏出去呢？
It's altogether another thing.
这是完全是另外一回事了。
Are you with me?
你明白吗？
A crisis of faith.
这个就是信心的危机。
We simply don't trust God enough.
就是信不够的来去信靠神。
to follow Jesus.
来去跟随他。
And that's our problem today.
这就是我们今天的问题。
Lastly,
最后。
And this builds up to the final, the third hurdle, that is the hurdle of lordship.
所以这也会引导我们进入到第三个的障碍，就是有关主宰的障碍。
Everybody say hurdle of lordship.
我们一起说主宰的障碍。
Okay, I already read it in English. Any read 31 to 34 in Chinese. Okay?
所以呢，我们来看。For
those of you who don't understand Chinese, okay, I think it's, you see it in bilingual, I guess, I'm not sure. Okay, but whatever it is, all right, it's talking about pigs. Okay?
所以呢，我来读31到34节，鬼就央求耶稣说，若把我们赶出去，就打发我们进入猪群吧。耶稣说，去吧。鬼就出来进入猪群，全群忽然闯下山崖，投在海里淹死了。放猪的就逃跑进城，将这一切事和被鬼附的人所遭遇的都告诉人，和城的人都出来迎接耶稣，即见了就央求他离开他们的境界。
The question of lordshipIs a question of who has full authority over our lives.
所以这个有关主宰的问题呢，就是说到最终是谁在我们生命里面掌权权。
Just like the second point of control, the third point helps us to see who is actually the true master of our lives.
所以就好像第二点讲到的这个的掌控，第三点是要帮助我们看见到底谁才是我们生命的主宰。
Now the contrast we see here in the final verses of this chapter, okay, of chapter 8, is that Jesus is Lord, He is the Lord, He is the Master over all creation and all the forces of darkness.
所以在这最后几节的经文里面呢，我们也会看到一个很强烈的对比。那么这对比呢，就说到首先耶稣他是万物，甚至是所有黑暗的势力都要降服于他的权柄。
The winds...heard his voice and command and obey.
这个风听见了主耶稣的命令，然后呢，风也服从了。
The waves heard his command and obey.
浪他也听见了耶稣的命令，并且服从了。
Even the demons hear his voice and obey.
甚至是连魔鬼听见耶稣的命令，他也要服从。
But strangely,Okay, once come to us, human beings, once come to us, his voice, his commands are just an option or a suggestion.
可是很奇怪的，当来到我们的身上的时候，他的声音，他的命令，只是一个的选择。
His commands are often answered or responded with reluctance or even rejection.
很常我们会用很勉强，甚至是拒绝去回应他的声音和他的命令。
We are not like the example of control just now, we are not willing to fully surrender.
就好像刚才有关掌控的这个的问题，我们不愿意完全的来去降服。
We fear if we let go, we will lose out.
我们很害怕，如果我们放手的话，我们就会有所损失。
We fear if we surrender, we will be shortchanged.
我们很害怕，如果我们降服的话呢，我们就会被亏待。
And even worse, though we don't dare to say it,We fear that God is not strong enough to carry us.
更糟糕的就是我们不敢讲出来的，就是我们害怕神他不够强大的来去扶持我们。
We fear that God is not strong enough to carry us through.
我们很害怕神不够强大，不能够扶持我们来去走过一切。
Interesting in this passage.
很有趣的，在这篇的经文里面。
You know, for the sake of those who have forgotten the Bible reading, okay?
如果你们忘了刚才我所读的经文。
All right, the issue is this: there were these demons. Someone was possessed, and in fact, the Bible says in another passage talk about actually there are a lot of demons in that one person.
所以呢，这节的经文其实就说到有一个人被鬼附，在另外一篇另外一个的福音书里面讲到，是很多的魔鬼在他的身上。
So there are two persons here that are demon possessed.
所以呢，在这里呢，就有两个人他们是被鬼附。
They recognize Jesus.
他被鬼附，他们认得耶稣。
They know that they will be.Okay, they will be condemned one day, but they are not ready to go yet.
那么这些鬼呢？他们知道有一天是要被定罪的，可是呢，他们现在还不准备好要离开这个人。
They know that Jesus has the power to cast them away forever for good.
他们知道耶稣是有这样子的权柄，能够把他们从这个人的身上赶出去。
And interestingly, they bargain with Jesus. Jesus, you know, we will leave these persons, okay, but allow us to go into the pigs.
可是很有趣的，他们会跟耶稣讨价还价。他们就跟耶稣说：“耶稣，好，我们会离开这个人，可是呢，你要让我们进入到这些的猪群里面。”
So demons not only can possess people, demons can also possess pigs.
所以呢，你会看到魔鬼不单只是会服人，也是会服在猪啊这些猪的身上。
So be careful of the pig, pork that you eat.
所以你要小心你吃的猪肉。
That's why you better pray every time.
所以你吃的时候一定
要祷告。Just in case you are worried after tonight's sermon, okay, every time you eat, you pray.
所以如果你听了今晚的道，你担心的话呢，记得每次吃之前一定要祷告。
Or else after tonight's sermon, then you go supper, you order urao roh, or whatever pork, and then 你拿着，哎呀，又毛贵哦。
要不然等下你去吃宵夜的时候，你叫一些有猪的那些的那些的菜，然后你就很担心，哎呀，这猪肉有没有鬼的
？Pick up the pork, got demon or not？
哎呀，有没有鬼啊？有没有鬼
？Okay, no. You pray. Okay,
不是这样子的，你可以祷告的。
Wait, Basai. Okay. Now another passage. Interestingly, Jesus allowed. You don't ask me why Jesus allowed it. Okay, but Jesus allowed.Okay, the demons to leave the two persons and go into the pigs.
耶稣就容许了这个鬼的要求。不要问我为什么耶稣会容许。可是呢，他们就是这样子进入到这个的猪的身上了。
Another passage of the Bible recorded for us that there are more than 2,000 pigs.
所以在另外一个的福音书里面就记载了，在当天有2,000只猪淹死了。
And so what happened is that the demons went into all the 2,000 pigs, okay, and they ran down into the lake and drowned themselves.
所以呢，这个的鬼呢，他们就进入到这个2,000头猪的身上，然后呢，这个猪呢就突然间发狂，然后就闯下这个的山崖，然后就淹死了。
2,000 pigs were lost in the moment.
所以呢，一瞬间就损失了2,000头猪。
It is a 4 million ringgit, at least a 4 million ringgit loss on that day.
在当天，他们至少是亏损了400万零几。
No wonder the people of that town, that kampong, okay, when they heard what had happened, they said, "Jialat lah, jialat lah. If Jesus continue to be here, our town will be bankrupt." So they went to Jesus and said, "Jesus, please go away."
所以当赫城的人听到的时候，他们就说糟糕了，如果耶稣再继续留在这里，我们就要破产了。所以他们就去求耶稣说，耶稣你还是走吧。
Because they only saw what they lost.
因为他们所看到的只是他们的损失。
They didn't see the two men that were delivered.
他们没有看到有两个人被释放了。
They didn't see the people, the precious souls that were set free.
他们没有看到这个宝贵的灵魂被释放了。
They didn't see that God,who is able to deliver and set free these two persons, is also able to revive and prosper the town.
他们也没有看到神他可以释放这两个人，神也能够来去复兴这个整个的城市。
They didn't see how God can actually revive and restore the families.
他们没有看见神也能够来去复兴他们的家庭，他们的生命。
They only saw and focused on what was lost.
他们所看到的，或者是只是专注在他们所损失的。
They were so blinded.
所以他们的眼睛真的是被蒙蔽了。
And they failed to see what God has in store.
所以他们就看不见神为他们预备的美好的事情。
The final hurdle demands us to answer this question.
所以这最后一个的障碍就需要我们来去回答一个的问题。
Who is truly the Lord of our lives?
谁才是我们生命真正的主宰？
Lordship means the one who has full authority.Control and final say of our life.
主宰的意思就是说到，在我们的生命里面拥有所有权柄、掌控和最终决定权的人。
I said again, lordship means the one who has full authority and control and final say over our life.
主宰的意思就是在我们生命里拥有所有权柄、掌控和最终决定权的人。
Is Jesus your Lord?
所以耶稣真的是你的主吗？
Jesus may be your savior.
耶稣可能只是你的救主。
Because you have asked Jesus to save you.
因为你求耶稣来拯救你。
But is Jesus your Lord?
可是耶稣是否是你的主呢？
Fully control of your life.
真的是完全的在掌控着你的生命。
Are we simply using Jesus just to meet our needs?
我们是否只是在利用耶稣来去满足我们一些的需要？
Or to answer our dreams and our wants?
或者是来满足我们的渴望，我们的梦想？
You know, this same challenge or the hurdles faced by the teacher of the law or the disciple?
那么这个文士还有这个的门徒，他们所面对到的这些的挑战？
All the lessons that we have learned from the Bible still applies today.
我们在圣经里面所学习到的这一切的功课，今天仍然是我们可以应用的。
The bottom line is this: What are you going to do about it?
最终就是你会做些什么？
What am I going to do about it?
我会做些什么？
Is this just another sermon?
这是否只是另外一篇道？
Is it just another hour of tickling our ears?
就是另外一个来去听神的道的时刻。
Now the matter of fact is this, my brothers and sisters.
所以事实上是这样子的。
If you have Jesus,
如果你有耶稣，
you have Him with you.
你的生命有他与你同在。
You may not have a luxurious life.
你或许没有过一个非常富裕的生活。
But at least you have Him.
可是至少你有耶稣。
Now I want to say that Jesus doesn't call all of us to suffer. No.
当然我要说的就是耶稣并不是呼召我们每一个人去受苦。
I mean, says suffering means suffering, no, like.Very throat one. No, it's not that.
这些受苦不说到你很惨这样子，不是的。
But do we go through suffering in life? The answer is yes.
可是我们在生命里面会是否会面对苦难呢？是会有的。
The matter of fact is this. Now hear this and hear this right.
可是呢，事实上是这样子的。
If you don't have Him,
如果你没有耶稣，
you will need to face your own storms alone.
你就要独自的来去面对你的风浪。
And worse still, you have to face your own demons.
更糟糕的，你要自己去面对你的鬼魔。
But if you have Him and commit everything to Him,
可是如果你有耶稣，你也将一切都降服给耶稣。
Learn surrendering to Him.
你学习来去降服与耶稣。
Then you will learn to sleep.Even in the midst of storms,
那么你就会学习到即便是在风暴中也可以睡，你可以安睡。
You are able to learn to rest even in the midst of pressure, stress, anxieties, and worries.
甚至是在面对很多的压力、很多的挑战很多的担忧的时候，你还是可以在主里面安息。
And you will fear no evil.
然后你就不怕任何的这些的灾难。
Because the Lord is your shepherd.
因为耶和华是你的牧者。
He will shield and guide you.
他会来去遮盖你、护你、引导你。
You know, I started the sermon with willingness just now.
那么刚才我在开始的时候，我讲到这个的愿意。
And I end with willingness.
今天我也要用这个愿意来做结束。
The question is not whether you are able or not.
所以问题不是在于你有没有这个能力，你可以不可以。
But whether you are willing.
而是你肯不肯。
Some people make things happen.
有一些人他们会促使事情发生。
Some people just see things happen.
有一些人他们只是在观看事情发生。
Some people wonder what happened.
有一些人是根本不知道发生什么事。
Which one are you?
你是哪一种人？
You know, tonight, before we all of us receive our newly baptized into the family of God,
今天晚上在我们在做最后欢迎我们的这个受洗的弟兄姐妹进入神的大家庭之前，
I thank God for this time and this sermon.
我要为着这篇道和这段时间来感谢神。
And I really thank God. And I want to end it with a.Yes, the message is challenging, and the message is thought provoking.
觉得今晚的信息可能会就是挑战你的思想。
But I want to end with something very positive because when you learn to surrender, when you learn to trust God, you know God doesn't shortchange you.
可是呢，我要用一个非常正面的事情来做结束，因为我要让弟兄姐妹看到，就是当你学习来去降服于神的时候，神是永远不会亏待你的。
And why did I say that? I'm very, very thankful for tonight because so happened that tonight, as I preach this passage, tonight in our passage, there is a couple, okay, who are living testimonies of God's goodness, God's guidance, God's leading, and God is the true Savior and Lord over their lives.
那么今天晚上我在讲这篇道的时候呢，在我们当中确实是有一对的夫妇，他们是一个活生生的见证，让我们看到神在他的生命里面真的是很真实的，是又真又活的神。
I'm going to take another five minutes or so. Please be patient with me. Oh, 10 minutes. I better don't promise too short a time.
Okay, because with translation, probably 10 or 15 minutes. 再使用大家十分钟的时间。
Because I don't want you to miss it.
因为我不要你错过这个的见证。
Because this is living testimony.
因为这个是活生生的见证。
And I have not prepared them.
我也没有准备他们的。
I just walk in just now to church, and then I just tell them be prepared for surprises.
那么我刚才来到教会的时候呢，我就告诉他你们准备好接受惊喜。
Follow me. Okay. Now in our midst we have Dr. Okay and Mrs. Dr. Moses, Reverend Dr. Moses and Mrs. Shaw Aful.
所以在我们当中呢，就是有我们的Moses, Aful 跟师母Shaw.
I invite them to come forward.
所以我请他们上前来。
Give them a big hand, please.
我们先给他们一个的掌声。
Let me set the background. Okay, ask them a few questions because I want them to answer. This is very candid. I just want to answer from their heart.
那么我会问他们几个的问题，然后呢，他们会重新发由心来去回答。
Because all that we have learned tonight, they have walked through it.
因为今天晚上我们所讲的这一切，他们已经经历过了。
And I want to let you know that it is able, and we are able to walk as the Bible taught us to walk.
所以我要让弟兄姐妹看到，就是圣经所教导我们要走的这条路，我们是可以也能够去走的。
Whatever Jesus promised is doable.
所以耶稣所应许我们的，我们是可以做到的。
And these are a couple that have walked that path.
所以这对的夫妇呢，他们已经走了这条路。
Okay, the first question, which year were you in Sabah?
2008, 2009.
Okay, in 2008 and 2009, they both of them, okay.Brought the whole family, okay, two sons,
four and nine.
所以在2008年、2009年的时候，他们夫妇带着他们的两个孩子，4岁和9岁，全家人来到沙巴。
Because God impressed upon their heart, okay, to serve in Asia.
因为神感动他们的心，要他们在沙巴侍奉，在亚洲侍奉。
And so by faith, they took that step.
所以呢，他们真的是凭着信心踏出这一步。
2008, they left the whole, they left America, they left their work, okay? They are teachers, and they left their work, okay? And the teaching career, step out in faith, all right? To Sabah with two children, age 4 and 9.
所以在2008年的时候，他们是在美国，他们的事业是相当有成就的。可是呢，他们却愿意就是放开他们的这个教师的职业，然后呢，就全家人带着4岁跟9岁的孩子来到了沙巴。
Completely trust the Lord.
他们是完全信靠神。
When they step out, okay, all right, I give a big background. Because I want to ask you only key questions, okay?
那么我会给大家一些的背景，然后再来访问他们。
Because stepping out, you know, I want you to understand, when they left,
我要你明白，当他们这样子离开美国的时候，
they still have their mortgages to pay.
他们还是有房贷款要还的。
They still have a lot of things back home.
在家里还有很多的东西。
They put the whole career path on hold or probably don't know what will happen next.
他们就是完全放开了他们的职业，不知道接下来会发生什么事情。
They brought two young children to come to Sabah who doesn't know a single word of Chinese or even Bahasa Malaysia.
他们带着两个孩子来到沙巴，完全不会讲华语跟马来语。
And as I understand,
然后我也明白到。
As I understand, okay, answer me truthfully, okay, truthfully, all right. As I understand, okay, when they came over, yes, they take that, they share with the whole church, and if because they still have the mortgage to pay and everything. Because when they come to Sabah, okay, Sabah only pay them Malaysian ringgit just for them can live through the month.
你要明白到，当他们来到沙巴的时候，他们的薪水是马币，然后呢，他们的薪水只足够支撑他们在马来西亚的生活。
Do you still remember how much the diocese pay you during that time?
你还记得当时候的薪水吗
？Okay. He's too shy to tell you.
不敢说，不好意思说。
不是很多就是了。根本就不多了。 Okay?
Not much.
All right? For us, maybe that money is enough for us to live daily, but for them, probably not even enough.
所以对我们来说，他们所有的这薪水呢，可以支撑他们的日常生活，可是对他们来说是不够的。
I just want to set the background first, and then I'll ask the major question. Bear with me, okay?
所以那请你们稍微忍耐一下，给大家知道这个。
Of course, when they want to step out of America, they share with the whole church.
当然，他们要离开美国的时候，他们也向他们的教会分享。
And then, because they still have mortgages to pay and a lot of commitments.
因为他们还有很多的贷款，其他的尾声。
So, am I right that church members do respond again to support you monthly so that some of these commitments can be paid?
所以呢，就有一些的教会的会友就是来去在经济上支持他们，好让他们能够来去还这些的贷款。
My question to you.
问题来了。
Did the support consistently went through throughout the whole years?
经济啊，这个经济上的支持是保持一致吗？没有，两个月之后就没有了。
After 2 months, it stopped.
两个月之后就没有了。
That's the reality, my friends.
弟兄姐妹，这就是现实。
It is easy to give 1 month.
你奉献一个月很容可以。
It's easy to give 2 months.
奉献两个月还可以。
But to consistently give and support and when people say out of sight, out of.
然后当你看不见他们的时候，
等一下 ，I forgot what.
然后你继续的
out of sight, out of mind. Sorry, I don't know.
看不见他们的时候，忘了他们的时候，你还会这样子继续的来？
After 2 months, people forget already.
两个月之后，人就开始忘了。
They have to dig deep into all their savings. Am I right?
所以他们就要挖他们的存款了。
Okay.Now, because of time,
因为时间的关系
I can tell you a lot of stories.
我可以告诉你很多的事情
To tell you frankly, I don't even know all these things. Only much, much later.
坦白告诉你，这些事情发生的时候，我不知道，我是在后来才知道。
In the 2 years that they were with us, they never say a thing, single thing.
当他们两年在我们这里的时候，他们从来没有说过任何的事情。
In the 2 years that they were here, I thought that they are very rich.
他们在这里两年的时候，我还以为他们很有钱。
America support you 吗 ？America dollar
啊，有美金支持你吗
？Now I want to ask you a hard question. This is honest, before God and.
问你一个很难的问题，要很坦白的回答。
By the end of 2 years,
两年之后
，all your savings,
你的所有的存款
，What happened?
发生了什么事？ Gone. 全没了。
They exhausted everything.
全没了。
So by the end of 2 years, they went back.
所以两年之后呢，他们就回去了。
Start all over again.
重新开始。
I want to ask you.
再问你。
This is the main question I want to ask.
这个是我要问的最主要的问题。
Okay, and I will pass you the mic.
然后会把麦克风交给他。
Did God shortchange you?
神有亏待你吗？
Tell me, if you don't mind. I know I put them on the spot. Okay,
这个是现场
make them very, very embarrassed.
现场问的，所以没有准备他们的。
For the sake of the gospel that I'm preaching.
今天晚上为了我的这一篇道。
How did God prove His faithfulness to you after you went back?
在你回去之后，神如何证明他是信实的
？After you went back.
在你回去之后。
You went back literally.Kosong, pocket kosong.
因为他们回去的时候，完全口袋是空了的。
Because after 2 years, we just say thank you, goodbye.
因为两年之后，我们就跟他们说谢谢你，再见。
Okay. In fact, I didn't know all these things. I said, why you want to go back? Stay longer.
我完全不知道这样子的事情。我还对他们说，哎呀，你们为什么要回去？你们要留久一点。
They said, no lah.
他们说没有啦，没有啦，我们真的是要回去了。
Okay, go back.
我就说好吧，回去吧。
Okay. Cut the story short. Tell me.
长话短说。
I'm passing you my mic. I'm passing you a mic.
长话短说 okay. 来
okay very quickly because of time okay either you or sure you can both share okay very quickly how did God prove his faithfulness to you from the time you go back and to where you are now
从你回去到今天为止神如何证实他是信实的
when we went back no job nothing the following weekGot a call for my former boss.
那么当我回去之后呢，我是没有工作的。然后后来一个星期，我之前那个老板就打电话给我。
Can't take the job you left, and even with a higher situation. And within a few months, God opened the door and we move into another property. But as we move into the property and we calculated everything, the very amount we have spent in our savings was actually the equity that we walk into the house with. Amen.
And she don't understand. Put it in a simple English. Okay. Okay. Answer one thing first about your work.
Okay. So, I got my job back and a better job.
我回去之后呢，后来得到一份工作，是更好的一份工作.
And we got a chance to buy another property.
然后呢，我们也有机会来去买一个新的房子.
And by the time we finish everything, bidding and everything, God opened the door. The amount of money that we had lost in our savings was the amount of money that was in the house that we can recoup.
Oh. 就是意思，我也不是很明白，就是说到 他们后来买了这个房子, 然后他们,
The value of that property, uh-huh. can recover all that they have spent.
他们买了这个房子，然后他的房价就是他们所有失去的存款的那个的数目。
The appreciation of it.
And by the time up to today, Shaw will tell you, God has tripled almost everything which we have spent here, including our career.
所以简单来说，今天他们所经历的是神三倍偿还给他们。
I mean, we could tell you, without a shadow of doubt, that God will never shortchange you.
所以我们很肯定地告诉你，神不会亏待我们。
Let me add in a little bit more. Then we will all clap. Okay.
Then we will sing. 我再加多一点，然后呢，我们就
You can take your place.
然后我们呢，就来唱歌。
No. I haven't. Not yet. Okay, all right. So, to make things, to sum it up.
所以简短来说,
how God tripled them? As we know that they are teachers.
神如何三倍的给他们呢? 就我们知道他们都是老师。
Now, from the time you went back until now, how many years has it been?
从回去到现在已经多少年了? 16年。
In a journey of the next 16 years,
在那个16年的路程里面,
you have heard from him personally that this is news to me too, that God has tripled where he was.
我也是今晚才知道的，就是神就是三倍的赐福给他们。
Okay, so much so that he can buy me a new shoe.
他也可以买鞋子给我。
That's why I want you to come more, so you can buy me more things.
所以他可以买礼物给我。
Okay, he's richer than me now.
现在比我很有钱。
How God has blessed him is that he came as a teacher.
神如何祝福他呢? 他是以老师的身份来。
And 16 years, God blessed him.
16年神祝福他。
Not only in his career, but also he has earned in 16 years 2 doctorate degrees.
不单只是神祝福他的职业, 他在16年里面, 他拿到了2个的博士学位。
He earns as a doctorate in education and also a doctorate in organizational leadership.
教育博士学位, 还有这个组织, 领导的博士学位。
I can tell you this secret. In America, when people invite him now, they pay him big money.
所以我可以告诉你这个秘密, 就是在美国如果有人要请他的话呢，要付很多钱的。
But he come here, we don't pay him anything.
可是他来这里，我们什么钱都不用还。
That's a good deal.
这是一个很好的。
And I want to say to Shaw.
然后我也是要问 Shaw.
Shaw, by next May.
就明年5月。
What would you earn?
你会, my doctorate degree.
Yeah.
他也会拿到他的博士学位。
My doctorate degree. My second doctorate degree.
She will also earn her second doctorate degree.
第二个博士学位，明年5月。
So next May.
明年5月。
So next time that she come back, okay, we will give them a big, big hand.
所以下次在他们再来的时候，我们再给他们一个热烈的掌声。
Hallelujah. Now, I want to come back to this, is that, was it difficult? I mean, looking back, especially those 2 years when you step out, when God said, follow me, okay? Looking back, was it difficult? Honestly tell us, was it difficult?
当你看回头，当你踏出你的舒适区的时候，那些年容易吗？
It was very difficult for me, and it was more difficult for my wife. It was difficult for me because first, I had to lose all the work I have done, including my retirement too, because I knew that was that. But for sure, her mother did not like the fact that we were coming here, and her words were, "Are you Moses, are you taking my grandchildren from me?"
所以呢，对我来说是很难的。可是对秀来说是更难的。我很难是因为我必须要放下我的职业，我的所有退休的福利。然后呢，对秀来说，她的妈妈就不是很赞同我们来。然后呢，就说为什么你要把我女儿、把我的孙子都带走？
But we have to assure her that God was calling us to do this.
可是我们要就一直的肯定她说，这是神呼召我们做的。
At whatever cost.
所以这是无论什么代价。
I want to ask Shaw to give a few words of encouragement to all of us before we sing.
我们请Shaw来给我们几句鼓励的话。
From your journey that you have walked through, you know, to see how God has faithfully led you, what words, okay, in 20, 30 words, okay, what would you say to the family of God here?
所以今天你看到在这些年来神如何带领你，你有什么的话语要和我们这里的人分享呢？
Two words. Trust God.
两个字而已，信靠神。啊，三个字，信靠神。
Trust God. Hallelujah. Let's give them doctor and doctor.
Okay.
All right. So thank you very much. Let us all stand.
所以弟兄姐妹，让我们一起站立。
The word of God is not only for our learning, it is for our living.
所以其实神的话语不是只是我们的学习而已，也是我们可以活出来的。
The word of God is not a story written 2,000 years ago or 5,000 years ago or 15,000 years ago.
神的话语呢，并不是一个在2000年前、5000年前、15000年前所写下的一些故事。
It is a living word that it is relevant, that is alive for you and I to hold on.
神的话语是活的，是有生命的，是你跟我可以来去紧紧抓着的。
All of us will face the hurdle of a comfort zone.
我们所有人都会面对到这个舒适区的障碍。
All of us will face the hurdle of control.
我们每个人也会面对到这个掌控的障碍。
And all of us will face the hurdle of lordship.
我们也会面对到这个有关主宰的障碍。
Would you and I, you know, we may not be there yet.
我们可能还没有。
But I want you and I to have that faith that as we sing this song, you know, we are not there yet, but we want to sing by faith, Lord, I want to be there.
可能我们还没有面对到这一切，可是我们要用信心来去唱这首歌，说神啊，我要能够做到这一切。
I want to keep on singing until I reach there.
我要一直的来唱，来直到我可以做到为止。
My faith is small now, Lord.
神啊，我现在我的信心很小。
Lord, I am weak.
我很软弱.
But by faith, I'm going to sing and I'm going to walk until I reach there.
可是我要以信心来歌唱，来以信心的来前进，直到我能够做到为止.
Christ, my reward and my devotion.
基督是我的奖赏，我唯一所爱慕.